Today I will show you a game called Perfect World, a game that is set in the traditional Chinese period, but with a fantasy magic twist to it. You will see why I'm telling you this, because from the moment you set foot into the game, or Po if you choose the untamed race, the game has an incredible feeling to it. This is amplified by the big structures in the main zones, the vast lands that are filled with monsters, and cool looking players that are flying all over the place. Yes, you heard that right. They are flying because this game is one of the few, especially back in the day, that lets you fly. Imagine to be a young male in his 5th grade when you started this game and you see the map full of players, all of them having different kind of cool mounts and some of them in the sky with big wings or raiding two-headed dragons or flying mythical Chinese swords. I had a blast back in the day and I remember playing this game for about 2 years. Today, the game is not in such a good condition anymore, but with the upcoming of the Perfect World 2, maybe things will change. Let's check this first impression of the game in this year and let's see what is different. Also, remember that this video is not a review, only an impression to give you an idea about the game. Before the gameplay section, you can support the video with a like, in order for it to reach more people. Thank you. Let's talk about the thing that you want to hear the most, and that is the gameplay. Perfect World has a top targeted action combat, and that is to be expected since the game is launched in 2008. You have at least plenty of skills to play with, especially for the original classes. I remember that you got one every 2 or 3 levels. This game also has transformations, mainly for the untamed race that is a human animal one. The barbarian, that is the tank of the game because has the highest base health and scaling, can transform into a white tiger that gives you even more health and bonus stats from your armors. What I don't really enjoy at Perfect World is that it feels a little bit laggy. I mean, when you press a skill, it seems like it has a delay to it. This thing really breaks the flow of the game. Not in a major way, but in a one that still makes you uncomfortable. For this first impression, I tried to play with the gear that I would get from the shop because the game gave me really OP items that I was almost one-shotting everything, but I was still too strong. This is understandable for games that are kinda old now and they want you to reach endgame fast. A cool thing that old MMORPG had back in the day was the location of your status points. They felt impactful and you could create your own build like this. For example, if you play a barbarian that is focusing on strength and vitality to be a classic tank, you would miss a lot of skills because you lack dexterity. For PvE is okay, but if you want PvP, you must put some points into dex just for that reason. Another example was the summoners, that are a mage class wearing cloth armor. Building them mainly on vitality and intelligence, you could put some points into dexterity and strength, so she would be able to wear medium armor, making the character a little bit tankier in the process. The game is open world, with a pretty big map to explore and do missions. Don't worry though, you have your flying mounts that will help you in this instance. Like I said before, each race has their unique type of flying mount. Untamed raids a beast that can vary to all kinds of dragons or insects. Humans have flying swords and elves wings. After the first expansion that had the new race, the developers got lazy and did not create a new type of flying mount and started to recycle those. Anyway, you have plenty of cool looking things to try, so you won't feel any need for more. You also have plenty of fashion options for endgame, like in any MMORPG. I remember that I was really hooked when I played back in the day of how cool players looked. Especially the one that were a matching couple, because in Perfect World Online, you can have a girlfriend. If you are not able to get one in real life, this game is for you. But be careful though, because some pretends to be girls. I don't exactly remember if you could marry, but it was cool that you could ride together on the same mount, and if you were flying, the girl would be in the boyfriend's arms, getting carried over the cities. It is a great feature to have in a MMORPG, especially in 2008. Okay, so let's talk about the story and the questing of the game. The game doesn't have a particular story. Nowadays, I see that you have some dialogue options and the cultivation path that is available at level 9, 19 and so on from 10 to 10 levels, which is a different kind of missions but nothing beside this. As for the quests, they were pretty basic, fetch flowers and kill monsters that are augmented with the auto-pathing feature. This thing made them even more boring. It is a shame that nowadays all games have this automatic rushed experience till endgame. I really enjoyed the journey to max level and I remember that I had a particular mission here about killing some monsters that were overleveled and I had to ask for help or wait until I made some more progress to be able to finish it. I like to struggle in games. I like to feel like it's worth investing my time to reach a higher level and it is a challenge not to walk in the park. Like I told in another video, I treat the experience until endgame in a MMORPG, like a single player game, maybe a co-op one. Okay, enough with my rant, let's check the character creation. Perfect World has a lot of classes and races. You can pick from elves, humans, untamed, tideborn and nightshades, each of them having their own classes. For example, humans can be warriors, mages or engineer, and elves can choose from cleric and archer. There are a lot more classes, but I won't stay to describe all of them. You have a lot of customization options in Perfect World, and the game is from a long time ago. It was breaking the market at its time, and I have seen a lot of different variations of funny creation. You can customize each detail of your face, ear, eyebrows, cheeks, and so on. What I can see is that I have a few presets for hairstyles on this class, but a lot of eye customization. One even had hearts into the pupils. You can make an outstanding big character, or just one with a big head if you want, and create some of the goofiest characters you can imagine. Okay, before we jump to conclusion, if you found value in the video and enjoyed the content overall, consider subscribing. On this channel, I'll present you all kinds of RPGs, MMORPGs, Souls-like, Roguelike, Metroidvanian, Survival, and basically everything that gives you loot in order to boost your character status. So, if you are interested in one of these mentioned before, you have another reason to subscribe. Also, if you like to drink a beer next to your gaming session, you are in the right place. This has meditation and stress relief purpose. In conclusion, Perfect World Online is a great fantasy MMORPG set in a fantasy Chinese world, with some player base still active even today. If you want to fly or marry in a virtual world, this game might be for you. You have plenty of classes and races to choose from, and the game still gets updates, also a sequel. The gear and fashion are awesome, so you can express yourself. On the con side, the questing is kinda boring, and you will have a lot to walk or fly if you don't have a teleport stone. But overall, the game is pretty great and it is worth a try, at least from what information I got in this first impression. That will wrap the video for today. Thank you guys for watching, and may the gods of good luck be with you in your grindy days. Also, don't forget, after a night of heavy drinking, be sure to hydrate yourself. See you on the next video.